Titled our concert Radiant, Sending Out Light, because that is what we hope to do, to send a piece of light to you wherever you are. Though this year has had more than its fair share of challenges, to say the least, I have often been surprised to find little pockets of joy. And one of these joyful things is the beauty of being able to gather like this on a virtual platform. We're able to spread song to many who would not otherwise be able to attend. Our viewership is both international and local, spread across the many lands of Canada that we call home. So wherever you are, hello. We're so glad that you're here. We'd like to acknowledge that MCI is on Treaty 1 territory, the original lands of the Anishinaabe peoples and on the homeland of the Métis Nation. It is our desire to honor the history of these lands and to respect our Indigenous neighbors. We move forward both prayerfully and thoughtfully in an effort to listen and learn. And so, with the snowy ground underneath my feet, I'd like to introduce you to our new classroom. Some of you may be familiar with the space, but many others may not know where we are. This is an alcove, or that's what we call it anyways, that exists between our two dorms. It has been the home of our choir since November. It's not quite as fancy as Bueller Hall. Just saying. It's one of many reminders of how much we have had to adapt as singers and instrumentalists this year at MCI. We sing 2 meters apart with masks. Right now we can only sing outside, and our time outdoors is limited by the weather. Our concert choir exists as 4 choirs separated by grade. We no longer rehearse as chamber choir, resonate, and illuminate, but instead have 3 smaller auditioned groups called the Mood Swings, the Accidentals, and the Intentionals. The distance and small group sizes make it difficult to hear each other, and being outdoors makes what little sound we have disappear. The masks muffle our words and make it difficult to communicate expressively. Each singer has to trust that they are not alone, because all of these elements make it feel like you are singing in your own small box of sound. However, we sing because we have to. We sing because we can. And even though it is endlessly hard, we have managed to find joy in what we are doing and recognize that we are privileged to even be able to do this much. We are doing this for us, and we are doing it for you as a way for us to share in the community that we so deeply crave right now. For this concert, we will be filming in 1 take. Our goal is to have this feel as much like a live concert as possible. So everything you see and hear has happened just like it would on stage, mistakes and all. There may be moments where we will need to wait for people to be in place, hopefully not. And you may see some of the tech crew that is capturing the video and sound. We'll largely be here outside, except when we move indoors to hear from our concert band. We'll be featuring mostly our grade 11s and 12s, as they have the experience and confidence that it takes to be able to rehearse and perform in this really challenging environment. And finally, we will share with you the hope of Christmas as we continue to exist in a season of waiting and wondering. So with that, I introduce you to our first choir of grade 11 singers. They will be singing Benedictus by Andrea Klaus. and it is my hope the words of this song will reach your hearts. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Grant us peace. May God's love radiate out to you. Enjoy.
And it came to pass in those days that a decree came out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. The census first took place while Quirinus was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to their own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed and for her to be delivered. She was brought forth her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Thank you. Now there, were in the same country shepherds, living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood there before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were greatly afraid. Then the angel said, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord." And this will be a sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling cloths lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward humankind."
Thank you. Hi, I'm Jody Friesen. I'm the band director here at MCI. Like choir, we've had to rethink the way we do band this year. So we started off the year playing our normal instruments, wind instruments and percussion and cello. And eventually when we got to code red, the temperature started dropping. We were no longer able to play our instruments inside, so we were playing them outside until it was so cold that our instruments were freezing to our mouths. So we had to kind of abandon ship, and we became both a bucket drumming ensemble as well as a ragtag ensemble of percussion, strings, and piano. So we've put together a short little Christmas tune for you. We hope you enjoy It Came Upon a Midnight Clear.
One, two, three, four, five, six.
In the cold and sometimes dreary days of winter, to be near something radiant is a real treat. An object that is radiant is in a state of emitting warmth and light. Of course, it doesn't become radiant on its own. It must first be energized so that it has warmth and light to share. For a human being or a group of people, it's just the same. At MCI, we long to be radiant, to be warmed by God's love, to have the light of Christ shine in our hearts. This is our longing, not just for our sakes, but so that we have something to share with others. This is very much at the core of our reason for being. On behalf of all of us at MCI, I pray that you, whatever your circumstances this season, will sense God's radiant hope and peace and joy in your life. I also want to say thank you for the many ways you support what we do here. Constant prayers, words of encouragement, sending us your students and encouraging others to attend. Generous financial support. Without your support in all these ways, we would find it hard to keep going. We were really blessed with generous support in December. One of our alumni pledged to match gifts dollar for dollar up to $50,000, and we more than exceeded that goal. Even so, finishing June in the black and paying down our debt requires even more support. If you would like to give, visit our website or call the school to find out more. And now, would you join me in prayer? Eternal God, ruler of all worlds and shepherd of the stars, your glory is revealed in vastness and in power, yet your greatest name is love. In this season, we remember your gentle coming, not to a seat of political power, but nestled quietly on the lap of a mother. We dare to believe again that love is more powerful than fear, that peace is stronger than hate, that darkness will never conquer the light. In this season of God with us, we offer you our gratitude for the gift of your presence. May we both know and share your love as your radiant people. Amen.
Sing hallelujah, Christ.
So it was, when the angels had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Now, when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. When the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, as it was told them.
Scripture reading, we found it fitting to end the Christmas story with a return to the beginning. As we continue in this season of waiting, we wanted to end with a reminder of our hope. May you find peace and comfort during this perpetual season of Advent.
Now in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a city of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph from the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and having come in, the angel said to her, "Rejoice, highly favored one, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." But when Mary heard this, she was troubled at his saying and considered what manner of greeting this was. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for the Lord is with you. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Highest, And the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end. Then Mary said to the angel, How can this be, since I am still a virgin? And the angel answered and said to her, The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Highest will overshadow you. Therefore also the Holy One that is to be born to you will be called the Son of God. Now indeed Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age, and this is now the sixth month for her who is called barren. For with God, nothing is impossible.
True love.